to another Max2Play video. Today we will explore the brand new Max2Play image dedicated to HiFiBerry Soundcards working with the Raspberry Pi. As usual, you can download it for free from our website max2play.com, and once you've burned the image on a card, you can already use it to boot up your Raspberry Pi. And once you've done that, you get to see this page right here with the HiFiBerry logo and our Max2Play logo, and the setup page where you can choose, first of all, your HiFiBerry card. Now in this case, I have the DAC Plus mounted onto the Raspberry Pi 2. So all I have to do is choose this one and click Save. And as you can see here, the system has updated its files, and all we have to do is restart the device and it will be ready and set for our new selection of the DAC Plus. Now this will take just a moment, and once we have the reboot done, we will get to choose from our three options to set up the system to our individual needs. These three options are kind of the archetypes for the use of the system. Now obviously we can use everything that the system offers us, but for example, if we want to just use it as a simple audio player, we can choose this starter system, which will just give us an easy and fast audio player without any music server and any additional programs. And this setup will turn our system into a simple but powerful audio player. The player comes complete with a pre-configured network share, a Samba share, through which you can feed it with any audio files you'd like. And the downside of this option is, however, that you have no AirPlay capabilities and none of the advanced options you get from synchronized players, since it's lacking a central server. Now we come to the advanced option, which is pretty much the system we have built around Max2Play from the get-go, with the Squeezebox technology, offering the option to use it as a real multi-room audio player system. And it offers a high-quality solution, since the Squeezebox server technology is cutting edge, and with the server at its center, this system can support multiple players at once, synchronized through the server. And we can also use AirPlay by installing the ShareTunes plugin for the Squeezebox server, with which we make the AirPlay functionalities available to the whole system. However, we do have to make some adjustments, so it's not the simple starter set that we see on this option. And then we come to the simple AirPlay functionality, which will just set up one player, the AirPlay player SharePort, and no additional setups, as you can see here, are needed. We just set up the system and can use our Raspberry as an AirPlay device. Now this has been pretty much the introduction to the system. In another video, I will go more into detail about this new simple audio player, which I've talked about but haven't gone into detail. As you can see here, it's already in the system. And please subscribe to our channel and have a nice day.